I wanted to show you guys how to solve this kind of system of equations. Here we have x plus 2y is equal to 3, and the second equation is x squared minus 4y squared is equal to 1. Right here, we actually don't need to do the usual substitution, meaning that we do not have to isolate a variable from the first equation and then plug into the second one. We don't have to because, take a look right here, what can we do? If you say factoring, then yes, you are correct. And by the way, this is an example of what we call a nonlinear system of equations because we have the x squared, you know, y squared from the second one. So it's not typical linear equations. But anyways, this right here, I'm going to just keep the first equation. And then for the second one, we can look at this as x squared and then minus 2y and then square. Factoring that, we get x minus 2y, and then times x plus 2y, and that is equal to 1. Now, what do we see? Well, here we have what? X plus 2y, and that is exactly what we have right here, and we know x plus 2y is equal to 3. Therefore, we can just say x minus 2y times 3 is equal to 1. And then we can just divide the 3 to both sides. So we get x minus 2y is equal to 1/3. Is this any better though? Well, I would say so because you can see the following here. Let's call this equation number 1, and this is equation number 2. And this result right here, I will call it equation number 3. Combining equation 1 and 3, we are going to get the first one stays the same. And then the third one is right there. And now this is much better because we have the 2y here and then minus 2y. So if we add the equations, they will be gone, right? So add them up. This and that cancel. We have 2x and 3 plus 1/3. Let's not put like mixed number. Don't do that. Improper fractions. So multiply the 3 and 3. So that will be 9 over 3 plus 1 over 3, so it is 10 over 3. So here we have 10 over 3. Then, so here we have the 2x. So here we have 2x is equal to 10 over 3. Well, I will divide both sides by 2, but usually if I write it as over 2 over 2, that doesn't look that nice because we see a complex fraction. I'm just going to write it as multiply by 1/2 to both sides so that this and that cancel. And then we get x is equal to 2 and 10 can be reduced, right? So that's 1 and 5. So we get 5 over 3. Now, once we have this, we can plug into the first equation. Totally use the first equation because it's easier, of course, if we don't have the exponents. From number 1, we get 5 over 3 plus 2y is equal to 3. Subtract this to both sides, so we get 2y is equal to 3 minus 5 over 3. And then get the common denominator again, so it's like multiply by 3. So this is 9 over 3 minus 5 over 3, which is 4 over 3. And then I'm going to multiply by 1/2 again. Cancel. So reduce here, we get y is equal to 2/3. So here we have it. X is equal to 5 over 3, y is equal to 2 over 3, and that will do it.